So, GV, the other thing you wanted to look at was merchant segment against funding instrument, right? You wanted to see within the merchant segment which funding instrument is used. I think that is what you were mentioning.
Yeah, so we want the rows, we want that whatever you had over here. Just go to the left.
Correct.
Whatever, yeah, electronics first, that thing we want on the rows. And on the columns, yes, you'd like to see the funding instrument.
Okay. Okay. Let's insert a pivot table.
Yeah. Another pivot table. Yeah.
Bread and butter. It is.
Pivot table is the answer. Everything. Pivot table is the way to do everything.
Pivot table, we look up. Those two are the key things that I think students need to learn for doing good analysis.
They have to survive. So in the corporate, they have to survive in the corporate world.
Yes.
Better learn how to use pivot tables. Yes. That's basically the message.
Merchant segment would be rows, and you wanted funding instrument as columns.
Yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
Okay, and now what should we do? We should look at how many transactions used a debit card for to buy electronics. That is what you want to do, no?
Number or value? Both. You can look at number, value.
You want, okay, first let's look number. Okay, how number. Many transactions?
Yeah.
Hmm? Yeah. So I will take count of transaction ID.
Yeah. Transaction ID, timestamp, anything you can take. Yeah, transaction ID you can take.
Okay. Count of, okay, this automatically came. But anyway, let's make sure that, so this is count.
Yeah. So what are we saying? We are saying that there's a grand total here. It's good. So you say out of a 483, okay, no, sorry. Out of 660 debit card transactions that are there in our database, 394 were used for?
Travel.
Like that, you have to look. Okay, that's what it means.
That is one card.
And horizontally, if you read, you have to say, but by value, it will look very different. They're saying 483 out of 483 total transactions that were carried out, in which electronics was purchased.
Yes.
That is more interesting to read. 483 electronic items were purchased, of which 119 were purchased with net banking, 140 with, what is that? Pay buddy later. Then wrap that.
Pay buddy pay later.
Oh.
Let me.
So it looks like electronics is a good thing for pay later.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, one potential.
It's a leading category, in fact, actually. Huh? So electronics is it for
pay later. No. Fashion is the leading category.
No, I'm saying, okay, no, I'm saying out. Okay, even fashion. Fashion is even better. Fashion almost everything was done with pay later.
Yes.
Electronics are quite a large number was done with pay later. But for even pantry also some pay later. Oh, yeah. Even pantry also pay later is. But travel is definitely don't do pay later. 31 only. Very interesting. And website services, iffy here and there. It's partly here, partly everywhere.
Yes.
All right. Okay. So, what are we saying? We are saying that fashion and pantry pay later. Electronics maybe pay later. Software also, website service software. Software also maybe pay later, but travel definitely not pay later. That's what we're saying.
Correct.
Wow. Interesting.
Also, probably others you should not show pay later.
This, I mean, it's not okay. Maybe some insight that Venkat can give us on why travel they don't use pay later.
Yes.
Okay.
And that can also be GV because I think the average ticket size in travel is high, no?
That is why you want pay later, na? But maybe they're using credit cards. I don't know. We'll find out.
We'll find out.
I don't know what it is. We'll find out. Last minute. Okay.
Okay.
This is fine. This is nice.
The next analysis we can do, like we looked at merchant segment against funding instrument, we can also look at perhaps engagement segment with funding instrument.
What is that engagement segment?
So engagement segment, GV, if you remember, Venkat was telling us, was about low, high, medium, about to churn. You know, how often does the person use PayBuddy in the last 12 months?
How often has he used? Okay.
Right. How often and what was the overall value of transaction that he did?
Okay.
So we should. So do you think it makes sense to look that also?
Yeah. Why not? Let's do that. Now we are saying that by engagement and by instrument, huh?
By instrument.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Which will look very similar to what we just did.
Right? Yeah. Yeah.
So I don't want it on a new sheet. Let's delete this. We'll just put it here.
Yeah.
We'll put it below this. So that we get the same sort of analysis, no?
Yeah.
And now, what did I say? We will take engagement segment as
rows. Yeah.
And funding instrument as columns.
Column. Yeah.
And again, we will do transaction ID, count of transaction ID.
Yeah, can do count of
transaction. Yes, we got count of transaction ID.
Yeah. Okay. Okay.
So now again, you see 499 transactions, but out of that, 824 were from people who were highly engaged. About 2,000 were from medium engaged, 1,000 from low engaged, and 1,000 from about to churn. Roughly looks like that, no?
Yeah.
20%, 40%, 20%, 20%, roughly.
Kind of a Gaussian curve is there. Yeah, I mean, something like that. I mean,
correct.
I guess the definition of low, medium, high, they may have set so that you get some distribution.
Possibly. Possibly. Yeah. Let me.
Okay. Anyway, so we got some split between. So medium is high and then the others around that medium there are. Okay.
Yeah.
Then what is it that we are saying? We are saying that.
People hardly use credit card. That's one thing that you know. Straight up.
The churn guys don't use credit card.
Yes.
Okay. The medium guys
also use low intensity people also don't use credit card.
Yeah.
No?
High guy is using credit card like crazy.
High guy is using credit card like crazy. Yes.
Yeah. And the medium guy also is using credit card. Not, but equally.
Yeah, but not as much as the high guy.
Huh?
Not as much as the high guy, but he's still not using credit card.
And also using, but look at the interesting thing here, Milan. The high guy doesn't use PayBuddy later.
No, he doesn't.
He's not using even once. Wow.
No.
He's a high engagement fellow with PayBuddy. This must be a concern, no, for him?
Yes. You should discuss this with Venkat, definitely.
No, he's not even tempted to use his PayBuddy product.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we'll ask him. I mean, I should ask Venkat. Something's gone wrong here. Whereas the medium, low, see the low guy, he's got heavy use of PayBuddy later.
Yeah.
So what are we saying here? What are we? And even the about churn. Fellows churning. Yes. So you got all these temporary guys who are using everybody later. It's like, which means it's flaky. You should tell him your business is looking very flaky, the business of paybody later. Right? All your low engagement fellows are using it, churn guys are using it. So maybe your business is not very solid, grounded.
Or maybe he wants to attract these people. Is this a way in which he can convert low engagement customers to medium engaged customers? That's another option.
Maybe. We'll ask him. Venkat should be able to give us insight. Something like that. Yeah. Either it's a concern or it's a strategy. We'll find out. Either we know it's happened by inadvertently and it's a problem, or it actually is deliberate. So we'll find out. What you're saying is deliberate.
Correct.
Okay, we'll find out. Let's find out.
Okay. And the third quick analysis, GD, we can perhaps look at is to see, transactions happen either on a cell phone or on laptop, right?
Okay. The table has that information. Okay.
He has given us this data.
It says,
if you see, there's also POS, by the way. There was, if you remember, you said there was point of sale.
He said that they have tied up with POS, yeah.
Correct. So let's see, depending on the device that is being used for the transaction, if there is a difference in what kind of funding instrument is used. Does that make sense?
These things which you created, these tables, we should do the value, no? Besides number. But I think we'll leave that as exercise. Students might be wanting to do it. Let them do the value instead of number. Maybe the picture looks very different because.
Maybe.
Yeah, we don't know. Let them do it by value. We'll see. Okay.
Okay. So let's look at what happens if you do this by. The sort of device that was used. And so now what will we do? We will say device.
Device is a row.
Yeah.
Funding instrument
is a row.
Funding instrument column.
Funding instrument is column.
And
count of transaction ID is value.
Count of transaction ID is value. Yeah.
Oh, I got it twice. Okay. Unfortunately, one problem with pivot tables is that every time you create a pivot table, the formatting goes off. It doesn't remember the format. That is a problem, but that is okay. We can live with that. Okay. So now what is this telling us? So one thing jumps out, GV, on this. Okay, if people are doing something on the mobile, their propensity to use pay later is much higher than when they were on the web.
1,003. But okay. So hey, one thing that first of all we have observed, Milan, is that the number of people mobile and number of people using web are roughly the same. Which is surprising, actually. I would have thought that.
Yes. And maybe this is the American market.
I see. Okay. In America, people tend to use laptop, right? In India, it will be 80% only mobile, I can bet.
Yes, I think so. Definitely.
I think so. Okay. So that is okay. So out of 2228, 1363, which is what? 60% of the people chose pay later. Man, what's going on? Something about mobile phones, huh? Wow.
Yes.
Whereas web, it's very small. 446 out of 255. So it's like
20%.
15 to 20%. 15%. 20%. Huh, not even 20, right? 25 to 15, whatever, something. Less than 20% of the people are choosing web, choosing pay later, whereas mobile phone, 60% are choosing pay later. Wow.
This is a good insight.
This is terrific insight. This is great, man. This is good news. You tell him. I think paisa vasool, as they say. I mean, we have done good analysis.
Yes. Yes.
Right? This is, I think, worthwhile, no? This is basically interesting analysis. It's telling something.
Correct. Correct. The other thing that struck me as very interesting, GV, is that the only people who seem to be using their POS terminals are people who have their co-branded card. Nobody else is using those POS terminals. Did you notice that?
Only co-branded credit card. Because only those will work, maybe.
Okay, maybe. We should check this with
POS. Only those. Only it will work only with those cards. It won't work with any other cards.
Yes.
Okay. All right. So this is good. This is really good.
So some analysis we have got of the data that Venkat gave us. Maybe we should go back to Venkat and discuss it with him.
I think so. Yeah. Let's do that. Yeah. Yeah.